Good to hear from you. The Council has sensed your arrival on Terrace. An intriguing world.
This planet wasn't part of my studies at the temple.
Centuries ago, Terrace was like Coruscant, a vibrant city world. Then, a powerful Sith Lord destroyed the cities of Terrace in a single day. They became dark, polluted swamplands. But the Republic has been restoring them, with the help of Master Sin Tyken. Master Tyken is an expert in this wilderness. We had received regular reports from him, but he has fallen silent.
Just how long has Master Tyken been out of contact?
Several weeks. We fear this plague has touched him too. Master Tyken was working closely with his Padawan, Eris Varanal, and also a captain in the Republic Expeditionary Forces, Captain Nellix. Eris and Captain Nellix are at the Republic base. They should be able to help find Master Tyken.
We will see what can be done for Master Tyken.
If Master Tyken is ill, shield him if possible, and try to learn more about this Plague Master. We will be waiting on your word. Good luck.
This is crazy. We'd have noticed any unusual activity from Master Tyken, but the Council says we... Ah, here she is. I'm Captain Nellix, Republic Expeditionary Forces.
It's a pleasure to meet you.
Pleasure's mine. My men will be glad there's another Jedi around. Master Tyken's been a big help.
This has to be a mix-up. My master is a renowned Kalish scout, a truly gifted pathfinder. Padawan Eris Varanal, at your service.
I have to see your master, Eris. If he's ill, only the Force can heal him.
But that's what we don't understand. Master Tyken isn't ill at all.
She's right. When the Council called, Master Tyken had just left with a research expedition. If he's gone rogue, it's news to us.
I'd like to diagnose Master Tyken in person.
Sure. The Council wouldn't send you if they didn't think their intel was good, right?
Regardless, I'm sure Master Tyken will want to meet you. I'll try and reach him.
Captain! Captain Nellix! We need backup! They're gone, sir! They're all gone! Captain! Can you read me?
What the... That's the Expedition Guardsman, Sergeant Valoy. Where's Tyken?
There must have been an accident. Those ruins are always shifting.
Their transmission got out. The team might still be okay.
I'll get a rescue team scrambled. No, damn. I'll never get them out there in time.
Take a deep breath, Captain. I'll get those men back safely.
Yes, right. Thank you. Meantime, I'll put a team together. Here, take a copy of the expedition's map to guide you. Watch yourself. There's more than pollution in those swamps.
Master Tyken's out in them, too. I hope the Force is watching you both, for Terrace's sake.
Can you explain what happened? Where's the best place to begin? Is there anything more I can help you with?
Oh, thank the stars. Give me a hand. I can't lift it off them.
The others are all... We're the only ones left.
Help! The heat! I'm burning! Help! Help me!
Trust in the Force. I won't let any harm come to you.
Jedi? Please, get Laria out!
And the Jedi holocrons, Tall. Their medical data could save millions. We have to preserve them.
No artifacts are worth endangering someone's life.
Holocrons are gone? You fool! What have you done?
You saved my life, Doctor. You'd have let me die. And on top of Tykan trying to kill us.
You're saying Master Tykan was responsible for this?
We were taking pollution readings in the ruins. But when we found those medical holocrons, we decided to get them back right away.
On the way home, Tykan lures us into a trap fall, ignites the pollution in the swamp, and stands there watching us burn.
Master Tykan is unwell. He's not himself.
Brilliant deduction, Jedi. Tykan had some wisdom for us, too.
Tykan said he was punishing us for letting Terrace be destroyed centuries ago, and that soon we would be joined by everyone at the Junction.
The Junction's an old purification facility the Republic retrofitted to process dangerous gases.
Hundreds of people work at the Junction. If Master Tykan is planning something...
Remember, the Force is my ally.
Wish it had been ours.
We'll start back for the base. We'll be okay. Thank you for saving my life.
Just don't underestimate Tykan. That man is dangerous.
Jedi, we just got a call from the Expedition. They said you helped them out, but the rest sounds crazy. Tykan attacking them? A couple of survivors? From a 12-man team? Tell me that's wrong.
Master Tykan lured the Expedition into a trap.
No! What if he was trying to lead them to safety? They ignored him and wandered off.
You have my sympathies, Eris. I watched my own master suffer like this.
I want him found. Found and brought to justice. Even if I have to drag him back myself.
No, please! None of this is his fault!
Master Tykan needs help. The survivors said he was headed to the Junction.
Damn him! The Junction's a gas trap full of civilian workers. Keep your eyes open. Tykan used the Junction in his restoration effort. There might be a clue to stopping him there.
Please, don't hurt Master Tykan. He's the only one who could save Terrace, and I need him to explain all this to me.
Welcome to the Junction, Jedi. Sorry we didn't have time to clean up. I'm hearing some funny rumors from my guys about Master Tykan. Is that why you're here?
Is there a way to get your crew out of this building quickly?
Could run a fire drill, I guess. Look, what's going on here?
Here you are. Hiding in tunnels? Ah, I see your eyes shining! Hey, stop whispering. I am a Jedi. I am! This changes nothing!
Such a dark planet, rock spires like fingers. Black rock that... Wait! The darkness flows from them. It must!
Master Tykan, can you hear me? I've come to heal you of this sickness.
Heal? Or hurt? I see the lies in you. I watched once in the dark place. Malachor was dark, then bright. I watch his eyes as we run, as Parcanis falls alone.
Tell me about Parcanis, Master Tykan. What do you remember?
Stop it! Stop it! My friend, no! I won't go back there! I'll stop all of you! And your Junction hoarding poisons like a leech, yes!
I'll free the gases you've stolen, and the shadows from underground. Your Junction will be dust around you!
What would Eris say if she saw you like this, Master Tykan?
One was very bright. Yuan? Sidoni? No. That's wrong. What will the Jedi do while the gas builds, hmm? Will it save the workers before they choke and die? But the gas will corrode the Junction, too. How many will die without it to cleanse the planet? Thousands? How many do you want to kill?
Thank you. Can you smell that? The maniacs busted the main gas line.
Sir, Rakkuls. Someone's breaking open the vents. Rakkuls are pouring in.
No. We need to focus on evacuating or save the junction. I don't know.
Don't panic. The junction's workers are relying on us to save them.
I'll evacuate our... Wait, I got a crew doing maintenance behind a blast door. They'll be choking on the gas by now. Please, I can't send anyone else back there. You're their only chance. Get them on their feet and out before the Rakkuls reach that section. Good luck.
Perhaps a closer study is in order. The Force is my ally. I will not fail.
You're back! And in one piece! I hope you didn't breathe too much of that stuff. We got the whole crew out thanks to you. Might take months for us to start clearing the pollution again, though. A lot of people are gonna get sick.
Trust in the Force. You and your men will get this place running again.
That's true. One crazy Jedi won't knock us back for long. Tyken's the one responsible for this. Maybe we can help you stop him. Here. Before he lost it, Tyken was studying the old Terrace infrastructure. These are the records it copied. But the encryption is pretty old. We can't decipher them.
Someone around here must be able to decrypt them.
The Republic base's computer should have the original codes. They'll get those records open nice and quick. Give those records to Captain Nellix. He'll set you right.
We should act now, as I see no point in delay.
We'll take care. You do the same, Jedi.
Come in, Jedi. Do you read me?
Is there a problem?
The base is under attack. Tyken got the jump on us. We need you back here ASAP. We've got...
I need you to watch my back. Tyken's volatile in the extreme. Captain Nellix, what happened here?
Should have known you'd make it past those things. Tunnels. Tyken must have found Rakkul tunnels under the base. He set those things on my men and the little Padawan. Eris, Tyken took her.
Where would Master Tyken take Eris?
Could be anywhere. He knows this planet like the back of his hand. All these people dead. Forget a trial. I want Tyken's head for this.
This isn't Tyken's doing. Not really. He's very sick.
Now you're making excuses? Eris was... Wait. The tunnels are still open. You have to seal the tunnel entrances before those things come back. Please, check the base and seal those tunnels, or the wounded are just... food for the Rakkuls.
Consider it done.
Thanks. And hurry. Thanks. Now we can treat the wounded without Rakkuls pouring in. But Tyken's long gone. Eris, that poor kid. He dragged her out there with him.
We may be able to find them. Can your computers decrypt this data pad?
What's this? Infrastructure data? Maybe we can corner Tyken after all. Damn! These records have those Rakkul tunnels all plotted out. Tyken knew exactly how to hit us. And looks like one of Taras's super reactors is still operational. It's damaged, leaking toxic waste into the ecosystem. From these readouts, it would only take a little push to send the reactor into total meltdown. And Tyken copied every file on its processes.
If the super reactor went into meltdown, what kind of damage could it cause?
If the reactor blows, we're looking at a chemical detonation that could take out the Republic's entire occupied area on Terrace. Tyken's access code is all over these records. This isn't some vendetta, Jedi. This is genocide.
I won't let you down.
Here's the super reactor's coordinates.
Please let me know once you've handled Tyken. My men deserve to be told. And remember, Tyken's still holding his Padawan hostage. Watch your back.
Too late, Jedi. You wanted too long, too long! But now the reactor will bathe Terrace in fire. No Black Rock, no Shadow. The Republic will not spread it! I can cleanse it here, cauterize the flow!
Think, Master Tyken. You're killing the planet you've been trying to save.
No, fool! No! Weren't you listening? Lord Vivekar promised to guide me!
Is Lord Vivekar in the room with us now, Master Tyken?
He is here. And everywhere. He is. He...
It's all right, Master. I'm here to help you, remember? Master Tyken explained everything. I see the beauty in Terrace that the Republic destroyed. His work must continue to save Terrace, and we will be together.
Believe me, Eris, I understand how this hurts. But your loyalty is blinding you.
You couldn't understand. Master Tyken has shown me the truth.
You would devastate an entire planet just on Tyken's say-so.
I only want the Republic to... No, Master. We should find another way.
What's this? Such brightness in her, and she dares strike against me?
Never. I will not fight you, Master Tyken, but you're ill. Let us help you.
This doesn't have to come to violence. Don't force me.
They all turn against me. You brought this darkness here. The purification of Terrace will begin with you.
Strength.
We were strong once. The weak perish on Terrace. No, please.
The darkness comes to swallow me home.
Close your eyes. When you open them, this nightmare will be over.
Darkness is gone. I am myself again. You've saved me. At great cost to yourself. I can feel it. I am truly sorry.
While you were ill, you mentioned a Lord Vivekar. Do you remember?
No. I recall the name, but not what it means. I'm sorry. I will go before the Republic and admit my guilt. Purge myself of this shame. I harmed so many and almost destroyed my Padawan. I'm not fit to be a Jedi Master.
Don't make such decisions in haste. Take time to reflect.
She's right, and I will always believe in you.
I must report to Master Seo Bakarn and the Council. There's much to be done. I'm sure Captain Nellex will want to know you're safe. Thank you again. I still can't believe the sacrifice you made for me. I only hope your burden does not become too great.
Thank you for sparing Master Tyken. I doubt Captain Nellex would have been so forgiving. The Republic won't understand. When Master Tyken turns himself in, they'll never forgive him for this.
The Republic knows the value of mercy.
I hope so. He needs compassion right now.
I was watching the reactor readouts. We live to fight another day, thanks to you. So, is Tyken dead?
Jedi aren't murderers. I've ensured Master Tyken won't hurt anyone else.
What? Are you sick in the head, too? How could you let him go after what he did?
Don't Republic soldiers swear to defend the innocent? Tyken is a victim, as much as your men were.
The difference being, Tyken's still breathing. I got Eris's checkpoint signal. You're careful about keeping your own people alive, I see. Oh, while you were gone, Master Seo Bakarn contacted me. He's waiting to hear from you.
I'll contact him at once. Keep up the good work, Captain.
Don't take your eye off Tyken. You let him live, you're responsible for whatever he does next. Good hunting, Jedi.
Congratulations for your hard work on Terrace. This must have been difficult for you. Master Tyken has already contacted me. A team is on its way to bring him before the Republic courts.
Master Tyken deserves an advocate. None of this was his fault.
True, but unfortunately, we cannot let word of the plague become public. Still, For such a notable Jedi to fall so far, plague or not.
Before he was healed, Master Tyken spoke of a Lord Vivekar.
Lord Vivekar? I don't recognize the name. We must begin researching this at once. Unfortunately, our Master Anar Shaddaa is still missing. If Lord Vivekar is responsible, you may be our only hope. You've landed on Nar Shaddaa. Few on that world will be pleased to see you, I'm afraid. Nar Shaddaa is a den of corruption, excess, and gang violence. It is ruled by a crime syndicate, the Hutt Cartel, that takes a cut from every black deed.
Nar Shaddaa must have been a lawful place once.
At best, it was a refugee camp for the Ivakai, the original natives, until the Hutts imposed their heavy industry there. But now, despite its power, the Hutt Cartel is clashing with a new group called the Guiding Hand. The Guiding Hand's followers are fanatically loyal to an unknown leader. I believe this leader is Duras Fane, one of the missing Jedi Masters.
What was Master Fane's business on Nar Shaddaa?
He went there hoping to quell the worst of the cartel's activities. Against my advice. Fane is an undisciplined maverick, but he has great charisma. Incredible skill at influencing others through the Force. This Guiding Hand has attacked cartel spice shipments, operations Fane despises, in a way that shouts Fane's tactics. It's him. I know it.
I'll find him, Master. Hopefully he'll be cooperative.
Fane has flirted with darkness for years. The plague may have finally tipped the balance. Even fighting the Guiding Hand, the cartel is immensely powerful. Second only to the Republic and the Empire. So far, the Hutt Cartel has tolerated, even aided the Republic. But if it discovers a rogue Jedi is hurting business...
The Hutts might even strike against the Jedi over this.
My concern is less for the Order than for the Republic. We must find Fane before the Hutt Cartel discovers his involvement. I have a contact on Nar Shaddaa who can help you, and Theron Cedrex. Theron is a professor of exotechnology. He was once a friend of mine, and of Fane's.
How do I find this Theron Cedrex?
Theron has offices on Nar Shaddaa's promenade. He's usually there, if he's not nurturing his genius in a casino. Good luck. And don't underestimate Duras Fane, Jedi. His gifts of persuasion are unsurpassed.
Hello. And welcome to the offices of Dr. Theron Cedrex. My name is Holiday, and I'm pleased to assist you. If you have an appointment, please make yourself comfortable while... Oh my goodness. What a darling outfit. I must get Theron to program me one just like it. Perhaps in a warmer shade, though.
Are you some sort of projection? Or a droid?
No. I'm more than that. Much more. I'm a fully sentient holographic life form, unique in the galaxy, or so Theron says. You're a Jedi, aren't you? If you're here to see Theron, he's... Well, I've been waiting for him to get back. For hours and hours.
Perhaps he's delayed. Does he often just disappear?
No, never. We can't bear to be apart, you see. Theron had a special order to design a weapon, and the customer wanted him to deliver the prototype to the Nikto sector. The aliens there hate humans. The Republic. Hygiene. He should never have agreed to go.
Give me directions, and I'll bring him home safely for you, Holiday.
I promise. I'll be ever so grateful if you do. The meeting place is in the Nikto sector's starship chop shop. It sounds like a nasty place. Please be careful.
Don't be an imbecile. The weapon's obviously my creation. If you use it against the Hutt Cartel, I'll be looking for my vertebrae in a trash compactor. Deal's off.
Manchi doti puna puna. Kabuk nuni snemo.
You won't serve your master by getting angry.
Chobut I kafstu an.
I'm begging you, please don't get him started on this again.
Tampio da pushi wompa, pu tula musta.
What does the Hutt cartel have to do with this darkness?
Piti do tenya go kaka jojo, da biska ku paliya, kabano tase makipuna, mali tuta odmishka.
I want to stop the darkness too. Let me join you and learn at your master's feet.
Ukili mo klunki, nik mi chawa wermo.
Most Nikto are only worthy to kiss up to Hutts. Seems like you can't even do that anymore.
Monki atacha kapa donka, jisa picha.
That was gratifying. You rarely see delinquents getting their just desserts on this world. And from such an exquisite young woman, too. Loveliness and a lightsaber, a rare synthesis.
I just want to know I saved the right person.
And Bite as well. How intriguing. Impressive title. I'd love to hear more. When your Trandoshan friend is gone. Tharin Sedrax, professor and exo-engineer at your service. Not that many around here respect my genius, especially those Nikto. Challenge the Hutt cartel? Where'd they get such delusions of grandeur?
I think you know the man responsible.
So Juris Fane has a vendetta against the Hutt cartel. If any Jedi Master would risk it, Fane's the one. That's why I was right. If the Hutts find out Fane is behind this guiding hand business, it'll leave the Republic high and dry.
Hopefully I can catch him before he does any more damage.
No easy task. The Hutts have their claws, well, appendages, into everything around here. Fane will have hidden himself well. Joining the Nikto. You may have been onto something there. I know a local gang, the Red Light Lancers. A bunch of tech specialists and slicers of ill repute. Rumor is, they're part of this guiding hand.
I need to be in that gang. A Jedi Master wouldn't need slicers unless he was planning something big.
I suspect you're right. But you'll need to prove your expertise, I suppose. This prototype would do it, though I hate to part with it.
Your genius will stop a rogue Jedi Master.
I wish I was immune to flattery. Here, and here. I always wear an earpiece at Handover so I can call my assistant Holiday. With this, we can speak privately. Here's the location. I'll return to my office. If Fane is using some kind of mind control, I have research to do.
This is Tharin Sedrax. Can you read me, Jedi?
I'm present and listening.
The Lancers leapt at the chance to hire me. Their boss, Klaysia, is at the meeting ground right now.
Where's Tharin Sedrax? The darkness is coming. The Lancers need the man who solved the Meraki uplink paradox, not some unplugged Jedi.
At least he can appreciate good work.
Forget this. I have to get Tharin Sedrax for the job. Master's orders.
He couldn't come. I brought my latest creation to show I'm worthy.
Impressive. But the Master said get Sedrax. Even a Jedi's no good. Bet you don't even know what a D3TR port is.
A D3TR port is used to fix computer spikes. Basic stuff. He's playing with you.
I came here in good faith, not to have my intelligence slighted.
Okay, sorry. Don't bust a gimbal. So if you were gonna slice Nar Shaddaa's traffic control towers, what channel would you cut?
Any channel, I suppose. Apart from 552. Too risky.
With the traffic control towers, it doesn't really matter. I'd stay off 552, though.
True enough. Pays to be focused. And this weapon of yours? What's the power source?
It's exotechnology. Nothing he'd understand. Tell him what you like.
It's rare technology. From outside the galaxy.
Uh-huh. Really? Not like I can strip it to take a look, I suppose. You're not Sedrax, but if you can build weapons like this, you're definitely Lancer material. In the name of the Master, the Red Light Lancers and the Guiding Hand welcome you, sister.
So, how can a Jedi help the Lancers and the Guiding Hand?
The Master wanted Tharin Sedrax for a special job. It'll do for your initiation test, if you live. The Hutt cartel shares a bunch of spice factories with the Empire in the lower industrial sector. The Master wants them destroyed.
Sounds dangerous. I'll take care of it.
Go to the Defense Network Control Room and disrupt the protocols on the primary control node. That'll trigger the factory's automated defenses. Turrets, droids, poison gas, the factories and their workers will be wiped out. The Hutt cartel will see what the Guiding Hand can do.
I'd hoped Nar Shaddaa would bring a true challenge.
We should have recruited you sooner. I'll be monitoring the cartel's defense network, so I'll know exactly when the job is done. Don't keep us waiting.
That's a tricky proposition, Jedi. Meet me at my offices. I'll get started on a way to help you.
Oh, Theron. What a deliciously daring idea. I'll have to watch out, in case you get any more.
Dearest Holiday, I always save my finest inspiration for you.
I'll just wait outside until this is all over.
Ah, hello again. I believe I promised to help destroy those Hutt cartel factories for the Lancers, and I found the perfect solution. A few years ago, I acquired a Sith Overseer's ID. I've modified it with the permissions to trigger those defenses, kill everyone, and bring the factories down.
I won't kill innocent factory workers. I want an alternative.
Jedi, those people make spice for the Hutt cartel, and Clasia won't be easy to fool.
I won't sacrifice people if there's any chance to save them.
I do have a resonator key, a rather rare device. Very well. Attach it to the primary control node, and Clasia will register its signal as a network failure. The Defense Network Control Room will be near the factories in the lower industrial sector. Once you reach it, I'll help you from there. I don't envy you. That sector's a toxic nightmare, besides which there's Imperial soldiers, patrol droids, and worse.
Stop right there. This is an Imperial control station. I'm authorized to use deadly force protecting cartel Imperial interests. State your business or get out.
You dare impede a Sith in her duties. I should take your head for this.
An inspection? I'm... Please forgive me. I meant no disrespect. Productivity is down, but... We'll drive the workers harder. Double our quota next month.
The Emperor himself requested this inspection. He will be most displeased, as am I.
The Emperor... We'll do better. I swear it.
You're a disgrace to the Empire. Your mere presence offends me. Leave.
Yes. Yes, my lord. At once.
Good work, Jedi. The primary control node is active. Attach that resonator key to the node. In a moment, Clasia will think the factories are being destroyed.
Jedi, it's Clasia. I've been monitoring the Hutt cartel's defense network. That operation was smooth. The factories never saw it coming. You've got real talent.
I wish to give nothing but my best efforts to the Guiding Hand.
No kidding. You definitely earned this, then. The Master himself has heard about you. He wants you to be presented to him, in person.
The Master wants to meet me? I hope I'm worthy.
The Master's waiting at our headquarters in the Red Light Sector. It's in an old store. Here, I'll upload it to your map. Don't be long. Our fight against the Hutt cartel is heating up, and the Master doesn't like delays.
Come, Jedi, don't keep me waiting. I've been looking forward to this, ever since Clasia mentioned his new star. Poor Clasia. Good slicer, but he really should get out more. He's almost as out of touch as the Jedi Council. Tell me, is Seo Bakarin lightened up, or is he still the same old stuffed robe?
The plague is saying this, not you.
This plague has enlightened me. Those Jedi rules, I rarely bothered with them before, but now I see them for what they are. But I don't have the patience to explain. In fact, you've become a nuisance I need to eliminate.
The worst you can do is make me one with the Force, Master.
Then give in without a fight, like a properly stoic Jedi. I'd love to duel you myself, but the darkness is coming. Destroying the Hutt cartel demands my full attention. Kill her. Bring me her head when it's over.
Jedi, can you hear me? Are you all right?
Maybe a scratch here and there, but the Force was my shield.
Can't believe Fane would do that to another Jedi.
Skocharad mask osla, svetod tranis, undapolua, your scalp pocket.
However, Fane may have made a mistake by using that holo transmitter. Check the holo transmitter, Jedi. Press the small switch underneath, and we'll see what can be done. I thought so. Holiday, my dear, would you oblige?
Of course. Oh my, Fane hasn't covered his tracks very well. I'll just untangle the signal.
Holiday? You're a slicer?
When I found Holiday, I discovered this enchanting woman was supported by a computer network of incredible sophistication. With so much untapped runtime, it seemed a waste not to teach her about slicing.
Found him! Fane's signal traces back to... ooh... Shadow Town.
What is Shadow Town?
Shadow Town is an Imperial prison for the most dangerous prisoners in the galaxy. Well nigh impenetrable. The security there is the best on Nar Shaddaa.
The Empire wouldn't waste that much security on merely violent prisoners.
Shadow Town houses anyone the Empire needs to watch but can't control. Assassins, insane scientists, experimental specimens. Shadow Town has such exceptional security because the builders had it designed by the best minds, including myself. Come back to my offices and we'll parse the problem. I also have something to help you against Fane.
Please, I have nothing but respect for the Hutt cartel, but this is...
They say a Jedi's behind this guiding hand. We've seen a Jedi coming out of these offices. Start talking, Cedrax.
Perhaps I could be of some assistance?
I'm with the Hutt cartel, investigating rumors that the Jedi run the Guiding Hand. Cedrax worked for them, and now here you are. I'll have to report this.
I'm just a friend of Dr. Cedrax. As for this Guiding Hand, I assure you, no Jedi are involved.
Funny, because word is that a Jedi Master's behind it.
Do you have any proof of this Jedi Master, apart from rumor?
Well, no. But my contacts are normally solid. Though the Hutts might be... upset if this is only a rumor. Maybe I'll run my info again. But I'm watching you. Both of you.
That was too close. The Hutt cartel is closing in on Fane. Your quick wit may have allayed suspicion, but we have bigger concerns. Holiday pinpointed Fane deep in Shadowtown's residential area. There's dozens of cameras, guards, and crazed prisoners between us and him.
First we get in unseen. Then we'll work with what we find, agreed?
I like your approach. In terms of Fane's mind control ability, I have a little something to handle that.
A little something? You're so modest, Theron.
I've been consulting with Master Sayo Bakarn, and I've built an exotech device that should prevent Fane from brainwashing us.
How can a device obstruct a Jedi's influence?
It paralyzes the part of the forebrain that's active when a Jedi tries to impose his will. It'll give Fane a short, sharp shock. Shadow Town. I never planned to see it in person. But I'm ready when you are, Jedi. Wait, Jedi. I need to scramble the Shadow Town camera uplink from here, but if the guard spots any glitches, he'll sound the alarm.
I can get the guard's attention. Just tell me for how long.
We only need a minute to muss up the camera uplink. When we're through, he won't notice the difference.
Hey, I didn't know there were Jedi prisoners here. Get back from the guard tower.
I was convicted without due process of law. Where can I argue my case?
What? You're a prisoner of the Empire. You don't get to argue anything.
You prisoners. Every day, more griping. You're lucky we don't just clean this place out.
Jedi, we're all done.
My apologies, sir. I'll get out of your way.
Get lost before I lose my temper.
I've marked our next target on your map. We should hurry. We can cut the power to Fane's hideout here, but it's complicated. It'll take some time.
Don't worry about that. I'll protect you.
Holiday, darling. A little help?
Forgot my... Ah. You're that overseer, aren't you? Can I... Now, wait a minute. What's he doing with the power junction? Hey! You're no Sith!
This man is taking the power junction apart on my orders. It's a disgrace.
It was serviced yesterday. Alert! Alert! We've got an infiltrator!
Fane's hideout has lost all power. Any security systems will be shut down. Thank you for having my back, Jedi.
The Jedi way is to serve.
This is our chance. We should hurry.
Very good, Jedi. You survived both my Morgu Kai and this dank little town. Yuan Par taught you well.
Master Yuan prepared me to face anything.
Has dear Yuan ever told you about Malachor III? The truth, I mean. During our mission, we had quite the affair. She was something in the day, and her advances became irresistible.
You're trying to distract me. It won't work.
But the truth is so very important. Our passion, it paved the way for darkness to enthrall the others and destroy our friend, Parcanis Tark. That memory tormented me for years, but now I'm free. Free of guilt, free of fear.
I have the ability to shield you from the plague and stop this insanity.
Fane, if the Hutt Cartel finds out about you, the Republic's finished out here. This has to stop.
My, my. You got Theron Sedrax to care about something, Jedi. That's a gift I want on my side. Now, serve me and... What the... What is that thing?
A little trifle of exotech. To ensure you won't be influencing my Jedi friend.
Ugh, my head. I should have known you'd bring one of your damn toys.
I didn't want to hurt you, but you left me no choice.
How dare you? You think you can challenge me? Enough, I yield. But kill me. Kill 1,000, it doesn't matter. Lord Vivekar will never stop.
Lord Vivekar? Tell me, Fane, who is he? Where can I find him?
Like darkness, Vivekar is everywhere. In everything.
His condition's deteriorating. We should act quickly.
Good. Fane's already down. That saves us some trouble.
Fane is in my charge. Explain what you want.
I'm an official representative of the Hutt Cartel, and that man belongs to us. The guiding hand has gone too far. Jedi don't get to interfere with our business, not without consequences. Hand Fane over, or the Republic sees what unhappy Hutts can do.
Fane belongs to the Jedi. Not the Hutt Cartel.
If the Hutts don't get him, every Republic agent on Nar Shaddaa will find their lives suddenly complicated.
The Hutts are businessmen. What's a fair price for a Jedi Master's life?
Credits do make happy Hutts, but your master there was bad for business. It'll cost you. I guess we can negotiate with your council over the details. Okay, Fane's yours, but we will collect Jedi.
We honor our agreements. I'll ensure it personally.
I know your face. I know who to find. Goodbye.
You made a break in the darkness, but it is only momentary.
Stay calm. It'll be all right.
I feel better. Much better. Wait, you look pale. Are you all right? You woke me from that nightmare. I've done some terrible things, haven't I?
Anything you can tell me about Lord Vivekar would help make amends.
Vivekar? It's all slipping away. I'm sorry. All of this. But fighting the Hutt Cartel wasn't wrong. Jedi should battle evil, not appease it.
The Order should take the battle to the Hutt someday.
And I'd be at the forefront, but not today.
Once I've freed the gang leaders, I'll return to Tython. I'm sure C.O. Bakarn is already preparing to lecture me.
Do consider listening this time, Fane. It might save you some tribulation in the future.
Maybe so. Thank you. Both of you. I owe you my sanity and my life.
Congratulations on your handling of Fane. Not to mention the Hutt Cartel.
Theron, honey. Someone's been calling our offices, Master Sile Bakarn of the Jedi Council, asking for our friend to call back.
Master Sio should know what happened right away.
I suppose. I should get back to my offices. Genius never takes a vacation. This was fun. Like old times with Sio and Fane. Anyway, glad I could be of assistance. Take care, Jedi.
Theron, look over there. Hey, Jedi! Yoo-hoo!
Ah, here she is, our fair Jedi. Fashionably late, making an entrance.
Is something wrong? Do you need my help?
After our thrilling sojourn in Shadowtown, I came back to all the contracts piled up on my desk. Humdrum. Tedious. Boring. And I realized, Nar Shaddaa's charms have staled. I want adventure, excitement. To see something of the galaxy. So, in exchange for a single billet on your ship, you can have the tech expertise of Dr. Theron Sedrax exclusively at your disposal. What do you think?
You aren't leaving Holiday behind, are you?
Wherever my Theron goes, I go. I promise I don't take up any space. This software shell is quite slimming.
Now, how could you say no to her, Jedi? Besides, good looks, brains, and battle prowess. We share a rare combination. Our kind should stick together.
Why not just drape yourself over her a little more, Theron?
Holiday, no other woman has the runtime to understand me like you do. Now, shall we go?
I've heard a report from Nar Shaddaa. The Guiding Hand has disbanded, and the Hutt Cartel has withdrawn its vendetta. Your handling of the cartel was extremely impressive. Diplomatic skill under pressure is a rare gift. Now, perhaps Duras Fane can be rehabilitated.
Fane's unconventional, but gifted. Don't force him to be something he's not.
I suppose great talent often comes with great flaws. I am glad your mission on Nar Shaddaa was a success, but now I have an urgent matter that requires your attention. We received a distress signal from the Republic starship Corrida, and we suspect it's plague-related.
Relay me the pertinent details.
The distress call only reported a Jedi had gone insane and turned on the crew. Of particular interest, the Jedi in question is Lorana Fane, Master Duras Fane's daughter. Fane is on his way back to Tython, but I've asked him to join us over Holo. I thought he should be kept informed.
I should hope so, Sile. Being a Jedi doesn't stop me from caring about my own daughter.
I may gain insight into this plague from Lorana.
Any discovery about Vivekar or how the plague is spread could be vital. You will dock in the ship's forward section, where Lieutenant Bella Wynn and her men have managed to find safety. Find Lorana Fane. Shield her if you can and see what you can learn. Go with care.
Hold your fire, men! Hold your fire! It's the Jedi the Council sent. Sorry, Jedi. We're all a little on edge.
Are you doing all right?
We're pretty shook up, but at least we're alive. No thanks to Lorana.
She was a great passenger at first. Happy, smart, interested in the ship. But then we were hit by an Imperial ambush.
Lorana fought them off, almost died from her wounds. After a day or so, she started talking strange and then the slaughter.
What was she saying that seemed odd?
Always the same thing. Darkness. The darkness is coming. But wait, that started later.
After the ambush, we put out a call for medical assistance, and a Jedi Master answered. He healed her right up. He was odd, though. Had these horrible scars he kept covering. Never said his name. You know, Lorana was different after he left.
It's possible he wasn't a Jedi at all.
But he healed her. The girl's as strong as a Rancor. It was a struggle, but we managed to trap her in the aft section. If I can just...
Lieutenant Wynn, Lorana's slicing into the Carida systems. She's taking over the whole ship. She'll start shutting down life support soon.
No! Jedi, please! You're the only one who stands a chance of stopping her! Do whatever you have to. Just don't let Lorana kill any more of my men!
I won't let you down.
Thank you. I'll release the lockdown for a moment to let you in, but I won't risk Lorana getting out. There's a comm device back there. Contact me when you've taken care of her, and I'll release the lockdown again so you can leave. Good luck.
Oh, what have we here? A little engineer poking around where he shouldn't? I wonder what this button does. Oh, was that the airlock? Silly me. Bye-bye, little engineer.
Lorana, you're ill. You need help.
But I've never felt better in my whole life. The ship is nearly under my control. Isn't it wonderful? The darkness is coming, but it won't take me.
Lord Vivekar has taken control of your mind. You must resist.
Lord Vivekar, the nice man who healed me, he warned me about you. But you're not going to kill me, Jedi. I won't let you.
No! I won't let the darkness take me. Go away or I'll open the airlock! I'd rather die than be taken!
Please, Lorana, I can shield you from the darkness.
Lies!
Lord Vivekar warned me about your lies.
The Jedi just betray and kill each other, he said. He's going to make me his apprentice.
Master Fane is waiting for you to come home, Lorana. Are you going to let him down?
My father? Wait, you're the Jedi who saved him from his illness? I was going to visit him before the ambush. And the healer came. Lord Vivekar. No. No, the darkness is coming. I can't stop it.
This won't take long.
What did you do? You look so weak. But Lord Vivekar's voice is gone. The voice in my head. How did you do it?
A shielding ritual that blocks Vivekar's influence. The same ritual that saved your father.
But it's taken a lot out of you. And the difference for me, it's like night and day. I just can't believe I let that monster make me do those terrible things. I'm sorry. I'm...
I'm going to lock myself in the brig until we reach a port. I don't trust myself.
Lorana, my child, my apprentice, Jedi. So, you have robbed me of a most promising student. As if that will delay the inevitable. You Jedi are an endless source of amusement.
We meet at last, Plague Master.
You know nothing of me, but I know all about your order. Once, I served the Jedi Council blindly, as you do. There is no emotion, only peace. I believed, but the teachings of the Dark Lord Terek Morridge showed me the error of my ways. Thousands of years ago, Morridge's hatred nearly crushed the Jedi. That is true power.
I already know how to stop the plague.
You mean your shielding technique? The Jedi do love repeating their mistakes. You know how the originator of that technique died, don't you? He sacrificed too much of himself and perished nameless. Everyone I have ever touched could fall to this plague. You cannot shield them all.
What if I used my shielding technique on you?
My power is already beyond your comprehension, and every moment makes me stronger. You are too late. I've already won.
I've restored Lorana Fane to the light. She's in the brig and won't cause any harm.
Are you sure, Jedi? I mean, she killed a lot of my people.
You're perfectly safe.
I trust you. You saved our lives. And if Lorana's in the brig, she should be secure there. I'll report back to Master CO immediately. You should do the same. Once we get the ship back under control, we'll set a course for Coruscant. Thank you for everything, Jedi.
I've just received Bellowin's report. I'm so glad Lorana Fane is shielded and well.
Thank you for my daughter's life. I have to go to her.
Did you manage to learn anything more about Lord Vivekar, the Plague Master?
He needs to touch the victims in order to spread the plague.
I'm listening. So this scarred man who healed Lorana Fane is Lord Vivekar. Amazing work, Jedi. Still no leads on how to find him, but we do know more about his plague.
What happens now?
I wish I had better news. But the situation has worsened. Two more Jedi Masters have now gone silent. In their last transmissions, both Masters said, "The darkness is coming." One Master was on Alderaan, the second on Tatooine. You must go to these worlds and investigate, quickly.
It may be a false alarm.
I hope so. However, both Masters were friends with Sen Tyken and Duris Fane. May the Force be with you on Tatooine and Alderaan. Good luck. Jedi, the Council sees you've arrived on Tatooine. Good. We can't waste any time. Tatooine is a vast desert world where survival is often precarious. Master Eris Vossen, one of the Jedi's best cultural explorers, was there when he dropped out of contact with the Council.
What exactly does a cultural explorer do?
The Jedi Council relies on people like Master Eris to develop relationships with the varied cultures of the galaxy. He can understand and adapt to even the most strange and violent societies. If this illness has claimed him, it would be a great loss to the Jedi Order and threaten the groups he was sent to study.
Any idea where I should begin my search?
Eris hired a guide to help him navigate Tatooine's treacherous deep desert and make contact with its residents. One of Master Eris' last reports was that his guide had developed the sand rot, an illness caused by prolonged, repeated desert exposure. The guide's name is Rowan Delk, and he is currently recuperating at the Dreviat Outpost Medical Center. He's your best lead.
Consider it done.
Work quickly. Master Eris is vital to the Order, And if he has this plague, well, you, more than any of us, know what that means.
Tyrants, damn tyrants, the lot of you. Treating a grown man like he's a baby. Like he can't take care of himself.
Lie down, Delk, and quit roaring. I swear, a Ranko with heartburn would make less noise than you.
I'll make as much noise as I want. Hey, Jedi! You a friend of Master Eris? Get Darth Nurse here off my back, will you?
She doesn't look Sith to me, but I did want to talk to you about Master Eris.
You two can talk, but don't let him fool you into letting him walk, Jedi. He's got the sand rot, and bad.
My man breathes in a little sand, and after 20 years guiding folks through the desert, he suddenly can't make decisions for himself. What's it you wanted to know about Master Eris?
It's important that I find Master Eris as soon as possible.
I'm listening. Jedi plague? Begging your pardon, but I don't believe it. Sure, maybe some masters. But not Master Eris. He's the brightest, most level-headed guy I ever met.
We've seen this illness twist even the most level-headed Jedi Master.
Look, you want to talk to him? You're welcome to it, but I'm telling you, he's just as sane as you or me. When I left him, he was in the desert with them annoying little Jawas. I really impressed him how they managed to survive out there.
Do you know what Master Eris was doing with the Jawas?
Studying them, far as I could tell. Trying to understand their crazy little culture, now. They're friendly folk, the Jawas. Even if they don't understand the meaning of the words private property, if Master Eris isn't still with them, I'm sure they'll help you find them.
If you didn't want trouble, you shouldn't have attacked me. Why did Master Eris instruct you to build war machines? Give me this message. If I help you get your parts back, will you help me find the War Maker? Give me the message, and you'll get your parts. I am quite honored.
Oh, there, Jedi. Would you look at this? They let me walk around the clinic. Soon they might let me cross the street by myself. Any luck finding Master Eris?
I didn't find him, but the Jawas said he made this for you.
What's this? A message from Master Eris? I know this encryption. Shouldn't take long to crack. There. Care to see what he has to say?
Rowan, you've realized by now that I've left those most resourceful of creatures, the Jawas, in pursuit of greater things. I came to Tatooine to discover the secret to life. Not its creation, but its ongoing survival. How do some species thrive while others fail? A great darkness is coming, Rowan, and to withstand it, we must know the answer to that question.
An interesting concept.
I believe that the Jawas, whose enduring civilization thrives in spite of Tatooine's harsh conditions, would answer that question. But during my daily meditation beneath the pillars, I saw a vision on the cave wall that showed me the error of my assumptions. I now know the true original people of Tatooine, the warriors whose knowledge I will use to stem the coming darkness.
What is he talking about? Who are these people he's gone to?
You really want to find this guy, don't you? I don't get it. Sounds perfectly sane to me. Master Ares used to take lights out to a cave near the rock pillars at night and meditate. Sounds like that's when he had his vision. Yeah, you're a Jedi. Maybe you could do the same thing.
Visions don't exactly work that way, but I should have a look at this meditation site.
You can use my old tracking flares as lights. The cave gets pretty dark. Just be careful out there. Rumor is the sand people are getting riled up. Don't let them catch you with your lightsaber sheathed.
Jedi! Did it work? Did you see Master Ares' vision?
What Master Ares saw wasn't mystical at all. It was a carving made by the Sand People.
A carving? Now, Master Ares never mentioned a carving on those walls. What did it show?
Let's see if I can explain this.
I'm listening. The Sand People are the oldest group on Tatooine? Doesn't say much for progress. Still, I bet none of them get the sand rot. I have a hard time believing Master Ares would do anything so cockeyed as working with the Sand People. At least the Jawas are good for droid repair.
He said it himself. He saw the vision on the wall and went to find the Ultimate Warriors.
Wait. What did you say the symptoms of this thing were? Delusions? Paranoia? What, violence? One group of Sand People has been unusually aggressive lately. Normally, they stick pretty close to their camps. I'm not saying I think Master Ares is behind it, but maybe it's worth looking into.
So where would I find these Sand People?
There's a farming settlement out at Malcolm's Dunes that's been reporting a lot of Sand People activity. I'll meet you out there. I know some of those folks, and I can help your investigation.
I thought you weren't supposed to go out into the desert.
Says who? Bunch of doctors never set foot outside an anchorhead in their lives? Besides, it'll do me good. Don't care if it kills me. I'm tired of being an invalid.
Listen, Delk, we got broken vaporators, a pile of wounded, and our food stores are almost completely gone.
That lunatic said he was a Jedi and a friend of yours. We trusted him.
You better have a pretty good explanation for why this Master Ares keeps sending Sand People out to attack us.
That's the Jedi I'm looking for. Where is he?
Another Jedi? Damn it, Delk. Why do you keep leading them here?
Listen here. We've already lost too much to that Master What's-His-Face and his army of Sand People.
So why don't you just leave here, quiet-like, and don't cause any more trouble?
I will leave when I find Master Ares.
Why should we tell you a thing?
I'm sorry, Jedi, but our trust is a bit worse for the wear at this point.
Well, Master Ares was nice enough when he came through asking to study the Sand People.
But ever since we pointed him to their camp, you could set your chrono by their attacks. We got nothing left.
The Sand People are your enemies, not me.
You suggesting we go out there and attack the Sand People? You want us to get killed?
I promise I'm not working with Master Eras.
All right. I guess we don't have a choice. I'll draw you out a map. In fact, some of our guys scoped out a side entrance you might be interested in. It's a little less crowded, which could be all the difference. There's something weird about these Sand People. They seem faster and stronger than normal.
Well, I think I know where that is. I'll get some gear together and meet you out there, maybe provide backup.
I can take care of myself.
Even so, I'd like to see Master Eras for myself. Still can't believe the Master Eras I worked with is the same guy who's causing so much trouble.
Rowan, Jedi, you're about to witness it. After weeks of work, finally, an end to the darkness. These people, these marvelous, marvelous specimens, have been tested, no, purified, in the crucible of Tatooine's harsh environs. They alone are the hope of the galaxy. Their strength, their society, is the blueprint of our salvation.
Master Eras, you are very ill.
No, not ill at all. They are simple, but long after the Empire and the Republic are gone, these people will remain. Their culture is built around strength. They cut the weak away like a societal cancer. Don't you see? It's the only way.
The only way to do what?
The darkness is strong, so we must be stronger. These are the ultimate warriors. We must follow their example and cut away everything that would make us weak in the face of our adversaries, the frail, the diseased.
You're not thinking straight. Now, look, I'm sick, Eras. You gonna cast me out too?
I have no choice. We must fortify the Republic with its strongest members and send this army of light out against the darkness.
You're not yourself. These are not your thoughts.
You fools! To oppose me is to reveal your own weakness. You will be cast out. No, wait. Before you strike the killing blow, listen to me. I hear Lord Vivica's voice. I've failed him, just as I failed my old friend Porcanus when he died.
Why does everyone mention Porcanus?
I don't know, but I keep thinking about our first mission, our ill-fated mission to Malachor III. We were all weak. We all came under the thrall of the dark side. We did things we regretted, but Porcanus was our strength. As we tried to escape, I fell behind, and he ran back to save me. He became trapped. We had to leave him. It was my weakness that killed him.
It's hard to lose a friend like that, but you have to move on.
I'm trying to. That is the purpose of this project. Think about it. The Jedi Order spends so much time protecting the helpless and caring for the sick when we could be fighting the Empire. You must kill me. I was weak on Malachor III, and I'm weak now. But you must take my findings before the Council. Promise me that.
We'll discuss that in a second.
What? What was that? You... He's gone. Somehow you've driven Lord Vivicor away. I no longer hear his voice. I almost wish you hadn't done that. Lord Vivicor twisted my mind, and I'm glad to be free of him. Still, my discovery remains. From these Sand People, I have learned the key to building the unstoppable army. I feel I must bring these findings to the Republic. Yet, I can't shake this feeling that some truths are best left buried in the sand.
To defeat the Empire, the Republic will need every advantage.
Yes. Knowledge like this mustn't be hidden. I will return to Anchorhead and make my report. Thank you for your guidance, and for saving me from Vivekar's grasp.
Well, Jedi, I can't say I would have done the same thing, but I'm glad Master Ares is alive and his old self. Best get back to Anchorhead myself. Sand Rot's acting up and, well, frankly, sort of miss Darth Nurse's hollering.
Watch yourself while I'm gone.
Yeah, I've gotten by okay this far. Good luck with whatever it is you're doing, Jedi. Hope you find this Lord Vivekar.
Master Ares has reported back to the Council. Good work. He speaks of discoveries on Tatooine. We intend to hear his full report when he returns to Coruscant. Did you discover anything more about the Plague Master, this Lord Vivekar?
Master Ares seemed to think that Vivekar was why he kept remembering Malachor III and his friend Parcanis.
A connection between the events on Malachor III and our current circumstances is clearly forming. The Council will continue its own investigation into the matter. Meanwhile, hurry to Alderaan. So long as Lord Vivekar has control of even one master, he will grow in power.
I understand perfectly.
Good. Do not delay. Every wasted moment works in Lord Vivekar's favor. Jedi, the Council is pleased to see you've arrived on Alderaan. Until recently, Alderaan was a part of the Republic. Today, it's on the brink of collapse. Shortly after seceding, both the Queen and the heir to the Alderaanian throne were assassinated. A usurper, Boris Ulgo, stepped into power, setting off a civil war.
Sounds like a rough place to be. Who am I looking for?
Master Sidoni Garen, one of the Jedi Order's finest strategists and diplomats, dropped out of contact briefly while on Alderaan. She's made contact since, but was evasive about her silence. Master Sidoni is brokering a peace on Alderaan. If she is suffering from the plague, it could jeopardize the entire peace process.
Do you have any leads on her location?
Master Sidoni was working with the head of House Organa's diplomatic corps, Hala Morgana. Find Master Sidoni and make sure she is well, that the peace process is not in jeopardy.
Welcome, Jedi. I'm Hala Morgana, head of House Organa's diplomatic corps, and this is my younger, more handsome brother, Lou.
Please, Hala, you do yourself an injustice. Your age gives you a stately difference.
If I wasn't wearing my extra years around my waist, I might agree. Now, Jedi, how can I help you?
I was told that you could put me in touch with Master Sidoni Garen.
Ah, yes, Master Sidoni. Truly remarkable woman. Well, you just missed her. She's at the Peace Summit. A Peace Summit on Alderaan. Imagine that. But I'll call her. The location of the summit is a secret for obvious reasons. But I'm sure she'd welcome your assistance.
Hala Morgana, I'm sorry, but I'm very busy right now. The summit is just getting underway.
I was hoping I could join you.
You're Master Yuan's student, aren't you? It's wonderful the Council sent you to assist me, but this is a very delicate process, with no place for a Padawan.
I passed my trials, and I think the Council knows what it's doing.
Only official representatives of the houses may attend the summit. What would the other houses think if another Jedi from House Organa showed up? And I don't have time to debate, if you'll excuse me.
Master Sidoni, I'm sorry, Jedi. That's really not like her.
All the more reason why I need to get into that summit.
Yes, well, Master Sidoni said that only representatives can go. Unfortunately, Organa's representative is already there.
Hal, House Teral, you know, with the beautiful daughter. Couldn't our Jedi friend represent them?
Huh, my brother is a genius. House Teral is desperate for a representative, but the usurper Ulgo destroyed their hopes. If you could help them defend themselves against their enemies and return them to glory, I'm sure they'd make you their delegate.
Tell me where I need to go.
You'll find Lord Teral in his house's last holdings, an enclave near Ulgo lands and Killik nests. I will let them know you're coming.
And beware the Killix. Those insect men have terrible tempers.
Chino hagwa buntacho, chubalong haku, yasa un kubas, taja bakta tunbunko.
I'm pleased I could help.
Wanta humpa, muri rava fupa jibampa wula, a king salikikava dumpa stupa.
Let's get to it, shall we?
A king salikikava dumpa stupa. Uwana wada blota wijawa, o wamawanga matuske, buka kambak nijit, tonka yiliska chanaga.
Are you Lord Terrell? I'm here to become your delegate to the Peace Summit.
Jedi, yes. Organa told me you'd be coming, but, well, this is... well, it's complicated. The whole house needs to approve a new delegate, and, well, they say they won't approve a stranger. Yes, of course, but House Terrell has fallen so hard, we don't even have the strength to hope. It will take more than my word to convince them.
It is my privilege as a Jedi to serve House Terrell in whatever way I can.
Really? Well, all right then. After our original delegate was murdered and Ulgo drove us back into this hole, I'd almost given up hope myself.
Just tell the Jedi our plan, Father.
Right. House Terrell's current position is precarious. Our enemy, House Ulgo, seeks our destruction. Their army is at our gate. House Terrell needs a strong ally if we are to survive. We need Haas Organa.
An alliance with Organa seems doable.
We had hoped so. We proposed a marriage alliance to House Organa. My daughter Fasha would marry Lou Organa.
But House Terrell is weak, and powers within Organa. Fear we'd drag them down with us.
We need to prove to Organa that House Terrell can defend itself against its enemies.
If you can defend yourself, do you really need an alliance?
We only need to defend ourselves for a short time to win the confidence of our prospective allies. As I've said, House Ulgo's forces are at our gates, threatening to drive us out of our last holding. But Ulgo's commanding general, Astor Vox, is a mercenary with a loose definition of loyalty. If we can reach him, turn him, we can break the siege.
I will begin negotiations with Astor Vox immediately.
We have no time to waste. I will contact House Organa the moment I hear that the siege is broken.
I've come representing House Terrell. They want you to give up this siege and join them.
Well, isn't this a surprise? The Jedi have decided to involve themselves in Alderaanian politics. You must be pretty sure of yourself to walk into a room of highly trained commandos. But you should know that I don't do business with just anyone.
My word is good, as is House Terrell's.
I'm sure it is, but that's not my concern. The battlefield is the only true test of a person's worth. War, bloodshed, these are the fires and forges of greatness. I only negotiate with my equals. Besides, my men are itching for sport. Best a pack of my warhounds, and we'll talk.
The Force will strengthen me.
Excellent. I've not had the pleasure of seeing a Jedi in action. Release the dogs! What do you think, boys? That was a little too easy, wasn't it?
Aye. Let's see a real challenge.
I trusted in the Force to see me through.
I'm sure you did. Not that I expected anything less from a Jedi. Those dogs were old, weren't they, boys? You need to do better than defeat a pack of geriatric mutts. No, you need a real challenge. What'll it be, boys?
Droids! Droids! Droids!
Droids it is, then. These are the best Ulgo has. Beat them, and we'll talk.
They'll fall just as easily as the dogs.
Droids! Activate attack protocols. Target Jedi. Excellent! Excellent! I like your form, Jedi. but I'm not entirely convinced yet. Sure, you can beat a couple of dumb machines, but what about Ulgo's finest warriors? Smart, fast, highly trained, and hardened by battle.
Rinkhodsbruk Sark, Trakva Grenok, Urkgrachos.
On my honor, this is the last time. Beat my champions, and we'll talk.
I've got plenty more where that came from.
Boys, you heard the Jedi. She's spoiling for a fight. Show her a good one. Most impressive Jedi. I didn't think House Tyrol had the resources left to recruit such a powerful ally. No hard feelings. If you knew how many fools come by offering me jobs.
Everyone needs to be tested every now and again.
Exactly. What makes us strong? Let me guess. House Tyrol would like me to stand down the army that's at their gates and perhaps join them?
Had House Tyrol made an offer to you before? I'm surprised you knew.
I'm a mercenary. House Tyrol may be the only house on Alderaan that hasn't made me an offer. I was feeling slighted. You can tell House Tyrol that my answer is yes. It's been fun working for House Ulgo, but there's no glory in working for the biggest army on the planet. I'll call off my troops and meet with Lord Tyrol immediately. Don't worry, I know the way.
Jedi, thank goodness I've reached you. There's good news and bad news. The good news is everyone's heard how you impressed Astor Vox and broke the siege, including Organa. They've agreed to the marriage alliance. Now the bad news. Lu Organa has been kidnapped.
Then we have to get him back.
Exactly. The kidnappers were from Ulgo's ally, House Rist, Alderaan's most deadly assassins. An Organa-Tyrol alliance would be disastrous to Ulgo. They must have ordered Rist to kidnap Lu Organa to stop the alliance.
I'll rescue Lu Organa. I promise.
Be careful, but hurry. We need to beat the Organa attack, or everything falls apart.
Jedi! Oh, thank goodness. I thought they were going to kill me. House Tyrol sent you, didn't they? They called about an alliance. I was riding to meet them and... Well, thank goodness you're here.
Do you know what reason Rist had for kidnapping you?
No. No idea. Maybe something to do with the alliance? I was going to meet with House Tyrol to discuss the marriage alliance, when these assassins swooped in and knocked me off my Thranta. I woke up here. But were they trying to prevent the alliance? Who would want to do that?
Without the marriage alliance, I can't get to the summit. Maybe someone doesn't want me to go.
Who would care if you went to the summit? Though now that you mention it, as I lost consciousness, they were talking about Master Sidoni. But how could she be involved? It has to be a frame job. It must be.
I believe Master Sidoni is very ill. But if I can get to the summit, I hope to help her.
I just want to trust Master Sidoni. Oh, I'm sorry. My head. I still get these pains from the fall. I can't leave here until I know if Master Sidoni was involved. The kidnappers used to go into the other room to contact their employer. I'm sure we'll find a comm device there. We just need to see who they've been calling.
I told you, I can't. Oh, Jedi, I appreciate your desire to help, and I will be sure to praise your zeal to Master Yuan. But I am extremely busy right now. I can't afford interruptions.
Why is your hollow frequency in House Rist's computer?
I would assume it's because Rist was invited to the summit. Now, if you'll excuse me, Jedi, I have very important work to do.
Wait, Master Sidoni! I don't understand. What was her frequency doing here?
I'm sure there's a good explanation, but I need to get to the summit to find out.
I hope you're right, Jedi. Please, I need to get out of this place. My head is killing me, and I keep looking over my shoulder expecting more assassins. I'll see that the Organa-Tyrol alliance is finalized, and that you get to the summit.
I don't understand. Why would you want to risk it?
Lord Tyrol, without risk, there can be no glory. The only way to avoid risk is to avoid war. But that's not very effective or fun, is it?
No, I suppose it isn't. Ah, Jedi, welcome back. General Vox and I were just discussing strategy. We haven't stood this proud since our house was young and building its first alliance with House Pantyr. Thank you, Jedi.
It was your plan. I merely executed.
But we couldn't have done any of it without you. Lu Organa and my daughter Fasha are getting acquainted as we speak. I spoke with the rest of House Tyrell, and the decision was unanimous. You are our new delegate. Congratulations!
Now I need to get to the summit and find Master Sidoni.
I have the packet the last delegate was supposed to use, but I don't understand its contents. Some coordinates and a data spike. It appears that you need to go to those coordinates and do something with the data spike?
We'll soon find out, won't we?
Just one moment, Jedi, if I may. We would like to ask one last thing. There will never be peace for House Tyrell as long as House Ulgo exists. If you're able to use your influence as a Jedi to convince the summit to strip House Ulgo, ensure they never hold a title again, we'd show our gratitude.
I would be honored to assist you.
Thank you, Jedi. We very much appreciate all you've done. Good luck at the summit. I hope you find Master Sidoni well and that all goes smoothly.
Manchi doti puna puna, kabuk nunis nemo.
I'm House Terrell's official delegate. I have authorization.
Monki atacha kapatonka, jisa picha.
So here it is, laid bare before you, the irrefutable evidence. House Ald has been conspiring against House Organa for years, preying on their good trust. House Thule is the reason the Pantyr heir was assassinated. And House Ulgo is merely a puppet of House Rist.
Lies! All lies!
There are holographic recordings, documents. You can't argue with hard evidence.
We trusted you. How dare you? You will meet our armies on the field of battle.
Please, everyone. There must be another way besides war.
Calm down. My brother's murder went unsolved for 20 years, and you expect me to sit across from his murderer and stay calm? Just keep quiet, Jedi. I do this for the good of the galaxy.
This is not the way.
I am a strategist, Jedi, first and foremost. I live by variables and outcomes. I have calculated the future, and for the galaxy to have peace, there must be war on Alderaan. I will not be shaken from this course.
Let's not let this fall to violence.
No, this is it. The perfect, pure strategy.
You're a fouler liar than House Rist.
House Rist takes exception to that characterization. Murderer?
That was 30 years ago.
We had an alliance!
House Organa has heard enough. It's clear to us that there can be no other course but war.
Master Sidoni set you up for this. She would see you all destroyed.
This child is barely more than a Padawan. Disregard her.
Master Sidoni is the only one telling any truth at this summit. Don't insult her integrity.
You would defend her, Organa. You've always been a little too friendly with the Republic.
At least they didn't murder the heir to the throne.
We didn't murder anyone. Rist did.
Yes, Rist put that usurper on the throne, but you ordered the hit.
Usurper? Our reign is as legitimate as any other.
Isn't there a court that can handle this sort of thing?
Where would you find an impartial judge? Everyone's allied to someone. These accusations go back 30 years! 30 years of betrayal and treachery!
30 more if you go to war. Don't you want to leave your children something better?
The Jedi has a point. Why do we have to keep doing this? All it brings is more bloodshed.
No, there must be war on Alderaan. The darkness is coming, and I must stop it.
Master Sidoni?
Listen to her! She wants war!
Fight the illness, Master Sidoni. Come back to the light.
Jedi, if you will not agree to be silent, then I will silence you myself. The darkness is coming, Jedi. War must rage on Alderaan for 50 years, and only then can we put an end to the darkness. But you haven't won yet. Once you're out of the way, I'll make them see. No, I won't fail. Not again. I'm so sorry, Parkhamis. I failed you. I tried to keep the darkness from coming, but I failed.
Be calm. I'm here to help you.
It's too late to help me. I failed. I failed, Parkhamis. It's my fault Parkhamis died. Malachor III. I miscalculated. He had to be left behind. He died because of me. Vivekar! My head! Please, I can't block out his voice any longer. You must kill me to silence him.
I won't kill you. But you don't need to hear his voice again either.
Jedi. What? How did you... I don't understand. My mind is clear again. And you're... weak. Will you be all right? What did you do?
It's a shielding ritual. It should keep Lord Vivekar's voice out of your head for a while.
Thank you, Jedi. I only hope the sacrifice wasn't too great. For a while, I thought I was able to block Lord Vivekar's voice from my mind. If you hadn't been there with your calm sense, I don't know what would have happened.
Master Sia will be wondering how you are.
I will contact the Jedi Council. I'm sure they'll want a full explanation.
I think I can safely speak for all present when I say that the summit applauds your efforts.
Indeed. But I have to say, Jedi, I'm at a loss as to how to proceed from here.
Let there be a truce, and let the summit reconvene at a later date to work on a formal peace agreement.
The summit will reconvene at a later date to discuss the details of a peace agreement. Thank you again, Jedi.
Jedi, I hear the summit has agreed to continue peace talks.
Thankfully, the delegates saw reason.
Thankfully indeed. We all owe a debt of thanks to you and Master Sidoni. My only regret is there's no talk of removing House Olgo's noble status and lands once the war is over.
I didn't want to risk undoing the peace by inciting another conflict.
That was probably the wisest course. I just can't feel safe as long as Olgo commands an army. But what am I saying? House Tyrell is far safer now with peace in view and Organa as an ally than we ever were. And I have you to thank.
You're most welcome.
You've done House Tyrell an invaluable service. I hope you will come visit us again.
Master Sidoni just checked in. She seems well, but very frustrated with herself. She reports that you were able to prevent war from breaking out on Alderaan, however. You've once again done very good work in a tense situation, Jedi.
I did my best, given the situation.
The Council has come to expect nothing less of you. Tell me, did you learn anything new about the Plague Master, Lord Vivekar?
I wish I could say I had.
I see. Master Sidoni was the last of the Lost Masters, and yet Vivekar still eludes us. Return to us here on Tython immediately, and we will discuss what you have learned. Lord Vivekar cannot remain hidden forever.
You summoned me, Master Sio.
Welcome home.
I wish we could greet you with better news.
Despite using every avenue available to us, we are no closer to finding Lord Vivekar.
Actually, I believe we are. A common thread binds all the plague victims. The loss of Parkhamis Tark at Malachor III. Vivekar's influence forced the sick masters to relive their failures on Malachor. This is revenge. Personal revenge. Only one man would have that much anger and pain. The man who was left behind. I believe Lord Vivekar is Parkhamis Tark.
Jedi, Parkhamis is dead.
Far from it, Jarek.
Yuan? I told those Padawans to keep an eye on you. You must rest.
No. My pupil, my fellow Jedi, deserves to hear the truth about Malachor.
Then tell us, Master Yuan.
Malachor III isn't just strong in the dark side. The planet is the resting place of the Sith Lord, Terak Morage. Our work on Malachor woke Morage's spirit. One by one we fell under his power. The things we did, still haunt me.
The Noeticons on Coruscant said that Tarek Morhage originally created the plague.
Then I've been punished appropriately. We paid a terrible price to break free of him. Harkannis was the youngest and weakest. We had to abandon him to Malachor's darkness. His sacrifice allowed the rest of us to escape. But it seems he survived and has taken Morhage's dark path.
You couldn't have predicted this.
I must make amends. I have a plan to help you find Vivekar. If the plague created a link between my mind and his, your shielding ability may allow me to use that link to find him.
No. You're already weak from the plague, Yuan. This could kill you.
Vivekar won't get the chance. I'll be between him and my master.
It's our best chance to find Vivekar.
Very well, Yuan. But we will monitor the ritual, and your former Padawan must stay at your side.
Thank you, Sio. I will go to the meditation chamber to prepare. Please meet me there when you're ready. Thank you for coming. I have made all the preparations for the ritual to find Lord Vivekar. I plan to create a connection between us, using your shielding ability. If it was Parcanus, this should work. Drawing on your strength, I will invert the link between myself and Vivekar, and use it to sense his location.
This ritual sounds dangerous for both of us.
There are risks. For one, the shielding you gave me on Coruscant will be severed. I don't know what will happen then. It's possible I could die once your shield is gone.
You must resist, Master Yuan. Don't give Vivekar another victory.
With your strength to sustain me, we will do what we can. No matter what happens, you must give me as much time as possible. Reversing the link may be a long process. Let us begin. Yes, yes, it's working. I can feel his mind, and I can feel...
She can feel the power that she's challenging. There is no hope. Jedi, you don't look as strong as you did last time we spoke. Yuan has drained your strength and made herself vulnerable to me. Still arrogant and reckless.
You were once Parcanis Tark, a brave Jedi. You could be that man again.
The past means nothing. All that matters is the future, which doesn't involve you. See how Yuan's will crumbles before mine. Fitting that two of my enemies will destroy each other.
It worked. Listen. Lord Vivekar, he's out in deep space on some sort of vessel. Here, take the coordinates. He surrounded himself with defenses. Send this. It's his code. It will give you time to get aboard. No, the darkness. Vivekar's will is too strong. I can't hold on. Please kill me. End it now.
There's a better way, Master.
Ah, the darkness. It's gone. But you look exhausted. You have sacrificed so much for me.
Hopefully, Vivekar should no longer be able to influence you.
Your shielding ability has driven him from my mind. Thank you. I must rest. Please, go to Master Sio and the Council. They should hear of what we've learnt.
The ritual was a success. Lord Vivekar is out in uncharted space. But he knows I'm coming.
Now only your shielding talent can stop him.
You've shown great fortitude and saved your master despite the odds. But Lord Vivekar will have made preparations, and he still has his greatest weapon, the plague.
Now that I know who he really is, I could return Vivekar to the light.
A noble thought. But don't take unnecessary risks. Your shielding ability is our only hope. Go to the coordinates quickly, before Vivekar strikes back. And Jedi, may the Force be with you.
I wasn't sure if you'd be foolish enough to come aboard, Jedi. But I can sense your presence.
Did the docking starship clue you in as well?
You are blinded by the light side. You can't understand what you face. Come to me, Jedi. I'll show you how light can be snuffed out. Tell me, Jedi. What was it like, letting your life force drain away to shield a stranger from me? How did it feel?
It hurt, but I endured it.
Pain makes us stronger. And the pain I have endured is beyond your comprehension. That is why I have won. You will understand soon, if you live that long.
Your power and tactics have got you this far, Jedi, but no further. This battle was decided before you stepped aboard.
I'm tired of your delusions. Explain yourself.
My plague isn't just a disease. It siphons power from its victims. With the proper rituals, that power can be channeled. Soon, the combined strength of your masters will make me the most powerful Force adept who has ever lived.
Turn away from this path, Parcanus. The Order can help you.
Parcanus Tark died long ago. Even Vivekar is merely a skin to be shed. Parcanus offered himself to me on Malachor III to crush the Order that destroyed us. He embodied my spirit.
I am no lost Jedi, no ordinary Sith Lord. I am Terak Morage.
A Jedi healer put you down once. Now I can finish what he began.
No one can oppose me. I am beyond flesh, beyond death.
I will crush you, Jedi! And your shattered body will fuel my rebirth!
Impressive, Jedi. You might even have triumphed, but my victory is already complete. My plague has spread farther than you can imagine. Jedi masters across the galaxy are succumbing to it as I speak. The plague binds these masters to me. Hundreds of them. The heart and soul of your order.
Free those masters, Morhage. Now!
And if I refuse, will you cut us down? Kill me, and you will kill every master I have ever infected. Everyone. Shielded or not, they are still bound to me. But what choice do you have? You cannot let me live, and I am deathless. Your shielding talent cannot harm me. You've lost.
No matter what, Parcanus will be freed from you, Morhage.
Ah.
This body is mine. Damn you, Jedi! When my strength returns, no matter the years, I will destroy you.
I'm still alive. You spared me. My mind is clearer now. But it was your duty to kill me and destroy Morj.
Too many Jedi have been lost already, including Parcanis Tuk.
Yes, Parcanis was lost. But perhaps he deserves another chance. I cannot return to the Order. But Tython has its hidden places, its forests. I could find peace there. I could go home. But first, Jedi, listen. Take this warning in exchange for my life. You can't trust the Order or the Republic. You may be their heroine now, but they will abandon you too. Remember that.
We felt it. A massive shift in the Force. The Masters you saved have reported a sudden improvement in their condition. The plague is over, thanks to you. And I sense Parcanis Tuk for the first time in many years. How can that be?
When he comes back to Tython, he can answer all your questions.
We persuaded the Republic to divert a starship to your location, just in case. The crew can bring Vivekar back to us. Thank you for all you have done. The Jedi Order owes its survival to you. Please, return to us on Tython. We wish to thank you in person. And we have a special reward for you.
We've been awaiting your return. Please, step forward.
You have saved untold lives through your defeat of Lord Vivekar and the destruction of the plague.
There's a title reserved for the most prestigious among us, whose wisdom and skill safeguard the galaxy. It hasn't been bestowed in thousands of years.
But you have proved worthy. Now the Council names you Barsan Thor, Warden of the Order.
I will do all I can to live up to this honor.
I never imagined your potential would take you so far.
And not a moment too soon. We have need of you.
We have received word that the Republic is facing a new threat.
I stand ready for anything, Master.
We need time to prepare a war council. The Supreme Chancellor himself will be attending.
Take time to rest. And you should record your journey in the Jedi Archives. History must know of your actions. Return to us when you feel ready. For now, the entire Order will know there is a new Barsan Thor among us.
We hunt side by side, Quizen. Whatever my score, you share it.